And tonight, the candidates are reacting to those numbers.
One calls them humbling, while another says they're irrelevant. Action 7 News reporter Melissa Colorado has their reactions.
In politics, polls are more than just percentages. They can be what defines an election. Tonight, Mayor Richard Berry is leading the mayoral poll from our partners at the Albuquerque Journal.
It's humbling for me to see such broad support across the city of Albuquerque.
In second place, Democrat Pete Dinelli. The former deputy city attorney says there's one major lesson he's learning from the poll.
What I did take away from the poll is that no one knows who I am, really.
Right now, retired APD Sergeant Paul Hay has the least support from voters.
The only poll I care about is the one that comes out on October 8th.
Now, the next 30 days are going to be crucial for both Pete Dinelli and Paul Hay. Not only do they have to convince undecided voters, but they have to sway voters who already say they're voting for Richard Berry.
30 days is a long time in any political career, so we'll see what happens.
Dinelli, who is relying on the city's public financing for his campaign, says it's now a sprint to the finish line.
I believe this is a high water mark for the mayor, and we're going to start peeling away that onion here pretty quick with our ads.
A race that could get dirtier, warns Berry.
The onslaught of negative and misleading ads is going to start hitting by Mr. Dinelli and his aides fairly quickly.
Hay says the findings from the Journal poll send the wrong message to voters. If the poll shows that Berry has such a major lead,
make it people feel like, well, there's no sense in going out and voting because my vote's not going to make a difference.
But all candidates can agree on this.
If your vote ever made a difference, it's now.
In Albuquerque, Melissa Colorado, KOAT, Action 7 News.
And Action 7 News will host a mayoral debate with the three candidates on September 22nd at 4 o'clock.